Hey guys, how's it going? It's Night Robbie with Open World Games, and we are talking about more Watch Dogs. If you are new to Open World Games, welcome to our community of over 100,000 Open World Gamers between Facebook and YouTube. We are covering Watch Dogs, The Division, and a lot of other great Open World Games, so subscribe to us on YouTube if you are wanting more. But today, we're going to be continuing our video series about the weapons and hacks in Watch Dogs. And I wanted to recommend watchdogsforums.net. I'm going to leave a link to them right in the description so you guys can go to them and check them out. If you are wanting a great community of fellow Watch Dogs enthusiasts, go ahead and check them out. I highly recommend it. I really enjoy my time out there, and I wanted to shout out to all you guys having a blast, and I will see you all online. I hope somehow we can all play together. I know we're all on different consoles and platforms. But anyway, let's get into the hacks of Watch Dogs. So I'm going to start out with some of the more unfamiliar hacks and some of the newer hacks that the community has discovered from watchdogsforums.net. And we're going to start out with what is called Intercept Convoy. And basically, this is where you're going to be intercepting armored vehicles in the game. I'm sure that they're loaded full of money. And again, this game has been referenced to Heat the Movie by Michael Mann. And in that movie, at the beginning, there was a scene with an armored truck, and I was thrilled to hear about this. I'm hoping the more the game is revealed around May 27th, we find out about Heist. That would just put it over the edge for me, because that would be an awesome inclusion, in my opinion. And then we have Hijack Electric Billboard. This one is really cool. In one of the previous trailers, they showed a mobile user jumping on to a console user's game and hijacking the billboard and sending a message. I think this is one of the coolest features. I'm hoping it's used as a system to give hints to one another when you're playing online with your friends, and maybe taunt other players when you are invading their game. That would be awesome if you could send them a message and taunt them in that manner. And then it also appears you can hack car alarms in the game to provide distraction. I imagine this would be better for single player, maybe even good for when you're invading other players. Then you could hack ATMs in the game, as well as track vehicles. Now that's really cool. I think you're gonna be able to track these vehicles and use your on-demand car service to gain access to them. Hacking is going to play a huge role in how you actually collect cars as well, so look forward to that. Then we have Infiltrate Private Life. You can be basically a home invader look into someone's private life and Aiden, he's getting a little bit pervy here. Then there's Scramble First Responders. This one's great. It was spotted on watchdogsforums.net. It looks like you could scramble emergency services throughout Chicago to cause a mass distraction. It would be really neat to use these to get through traffic as well, because traffic would be cleared as you tried to make an escape or something like that. You even have helicopters that can be hacked. I don't know if you can hack such things as airplanes, but it would be cool to take those down if they are only enemies. I don't want to see civilian airplanes crashing for obvious reasons. And then you have the ability to hack traffic lights as well. You have drawbridges, which is going to be a lot of fun for doing stunts online and stopping other players from following you. You can, of course, hack phones, gain access to information in that manner. Street blockers is going to be key during races online and then against the cops. IEDs is really interesting. You will be able to hack IEDs and other type of devices, like C4 even. And then there will be enemies that are wearing IEDs, and you'll be able to set off that explosion. And some weapons will be hackable. There is a weapon that recognizes handprints, so it would be cool to be able to reprogram that and possibly shut down certain weapons that enemies use. Then you have cameras you can hack into, and this is going to be extremely useful for surveying the situation before going in and deciding on what to do. So you can actually plan out stealth if you are wanting to take that route. Then you have electrical boxes and power supplies that you can overload. This is going to be extremely useful when chasing someone down and causing distractions. You can also basically hack the entire city This is going to be where you hack the power grid to the city and shut down everything, and it's going to be very useful for getting out of the worst situation, especially against cops, because the cops are going to be very aggressive in this game, especially if you attack them. From what I'm hearing, if you kill a cop in this game, it's going to be very, very bad news for you, so be careful in that regard. And we all know you can hack the L train in the game. You can hop aboard this train and activate it and get out of sticky situations in that manner as well. Doors and garages can also be hacked. And then there's forklifts and cranes and something called protectors. This is going to be extremely useful for when you are getting into position and taking on other enemies, or just using it as a stealth mechanic as well. CTOS control centers are a huge part of the game. This is where you're going to be hacking the main servers of CTOS and gaining access to the cell phones and the cell towers in the game. And then you're going to be able to take on other missions like criminal activities and then have access to all the cell phone information throughout the city. So you're definitely going to want to take over as many control centers as possible. Of course, that's going to give you access to hacking people. This is a huge part of the game. You're going to be able to hack anyone and everyone throughout the city, find out where they live, who they are, what their jobs are, and their hobbies, and also look up any career criminals and track them down. That's going to be fun. I can't wait to do that. That's going to be one of my favorite activities, is really acting like a vigilante in Chicago. CTOS towers can be hacked. Steam jets and steam pipes can also be hacked. These are going to be very useful for when you are in chases and that sort of thing. There are so many more hacks to be explored in Watch Dogs. There's over 100 of them, as I recall. So stay tuned for that. I'm going to be covering nearly all of them on Open World Games. So if you are wanting coverage of the hacks, multiplayer, weapons, anything and everything Watch Dogs, go ahead and press subscribe on YouTube and then follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.